Yeah, so the next one is deals with precipitates. This is like section B of the lab. We add hydrochloric acid and sodium chloride together, and it forms a precipitate, a little white, salty thing at the bottom.
Just goes to the white precipitate.
Yeah. But then we add water, and it just kind of fades out. Is that just because the concentration?
Concentration, it just must be saturated.
Okay. All right, I mean, that's simple. You get that?
Yeah.
Because you added it in, you said you had white.
Yeah.
Yeah, so when you added NaCl, how's it like that?
We added a milliliter of 12 molarity HCl and 5 milliliters of 5.4 molarity NaCl. So whatever balance, but we had precipitate at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And then add water.
And asks us to write the equilibrium equation for the saturated NaCl solution.
Write the balance. Sorry, what did you say?
Write the equilibrium equation.
For?
So, for the NaCl solution. Okay, so the sodium chloride is solid, right? So equilibrium equation.
It solid when you
that was aqueous. When we first have it, that's aqueous, and then it goes to sodium chloride precipitate, correct?
Yeah, apparently.
So when you're doing this, when we're doing an equilibrium one, is it just like the concentration, like the reactions over products?
Equilibrium?
What's the equilibrium equation mean?
For what?
Yes. Yes, keep going. That's right.
Wait, what does he want?
Just asking us for the equilibrium equation for a saturated sodium chloride solution. So, yeah.
He doesn't give you like this.
He gives...
it's just NaCl equals Na plus Cl.
He just told you NaCl goes to Na plus Cl?
Yeah. So we'll just be I love these. I really do. This test is kind of rocking from when you just started with this section.
I don't know what he wants for this one. Which number is this?
Number 9.
This equation describes the equilibrium in the saturated solution, even if you don't see any solid present. Okay. What did it say before? When a precipitate forms in a solution, the solid is in equilibrium with the ions that remain undissolved. This can be illustrated with this.
Mm-hmm.
This equation describes that. Add 1 milliliter of 12 molar HCl to 5 milliliters of 5.4 molar NaCl solution. Note the change. Write the equilibrium equation for a saturated NaCl solution. So I think he wants you to write one of these.
Yeah.
This kind of thing.
So HCl plus NaCl equals something? Is that kind of...
Okay. So you kept adding HCl until it went away. That's what you did?
We add water.
Water and then it goes. goes back into a clear.
Now add 5 milliliters of distilled water to the mixture, account for any change, add more water if necessary, and stir the mixture until you see a change. And it just went away.
Yeah, pretty sure.
Nobody wants to get it right. I mean, it's weird because he says write it for a saturated in acetyl solution, but gave it to you right there. I guess you have HCl over here too. HCl plus that gives you...
HCl.
Explain your observations in terms of less chlorinated principle, but you're careful to tell molar HCl. Yeah. It's not user friendly.
So would it just shift it back to the product when you add the water? So it shifted back to its aqueous form?
Yeah, so it's going to go to an aqueous form. Because the water gets in between the bonds. What's the question that he gives? For number 11.
Write the equation for equilibrium. Explain what you observed in terms of Lachapelle's principle.
What you observed when concentrated HCl was added to that. So what you saw was... Okay, what you guys saw... You saw a precipitate form.
Mm-hmm.
So, when did you have seen this?
Still solid. Yeah, but when you also have HCl on the other side as well.
So yeah, you're going to have HCl.
And then when it dissociate with the...
HCl?
Well, there's no water.
There's no water.
Okay.
Yeah, because if you look, like, yeah, it's just not really gonna do anything. Because, okay, so you poured in this, so it must have been aqueous when you did it. But then you gotta precipitate, so your precipitate must be your product.
Right.